What's up, ladies and gents? I've got something special for you today. We are taking a look at the game Pollen. This is a VR simulation type of game. However, you do not have to have a VR machine in order to run it. You don't have to have the Oculus Rift or anything like that. You can actually play this in 2D standard mode, which is what we're going to be doing. It's really fun. It's very atmospheric. It's a space exploration, so I don't want to ruin too much of the story up front, so we're going to play for just a little bit, show you guys some gameplay. Let me know if you enjoy it and if you would like to see more. I'll show you guys some of the options here. You can only do... the highest you can do is 1080p. Actually, that's not correct. Oh, okay. You can go actually in 4K. What do you know? I didn't actually think you could do 4K. There's no real reason to run this game in 4K unless you're... I don't even know if it's really a reason to run it in 4K on VR. I don't even think you could do that. But the game does look very superb, and I'm going to be showing you 1920 by 1080 here. The field of view is so awesome because you can go super far out, or you can bring it all the way in. I'm going to go somewhere in the middle, let's say 77. That's for your presets. You got your VR, which everything is pretty much set on... high here, so this is as realistic, I guess, their way of saying it's realistic as possible. I love the little sounds that it makes, but everything is set up to the highest fidelity that it can be. Sound, keyboard, we're going to be using a controller. And of course, you can set up the Oculus Rift and all that kind of stuff to, you know, fine-tune all of that as well, if you would like to. But we're going to go ahead and get right into this. I played a little bit of it. I got sucked into it. Like, I didn't know I was going to like it as much as I have. And it's really, really fun. The game doesn't hold your hand at all, so you have to figure everything out for yourself. We're just going to show a little bit of gameplay, and hopefully you guys enjoy. It's go time.
Thank you for answering the social relationship section of this interview. Now, for the last section, please answer the questions as truthfully and as quickly as possible. Thank you for your willingness to work for Rama Industries. We are now processing your PAT4C2 answers. While we evaluate the answers, please take a look at the benefits and terms of agreement on your right and left. We have found a position matching your profile by
87%.
Please, have a pleasant assignment with Rama Industries. Press the red button to accept the terms and conditions and begin working.
Technician of Base M. We have lost our communication link with the base. Re-establish the comm link between HQ and the comm station. When this is done, we will send further instructions. HQ out.
Hey,
Here we go, ladies and gents. Love these space-time simulation games here. Remember, this the gravity here is very low, so you can actually kind of float a little bit. Looks like there's a storm warning in effect.
Data won't reach Basie. There's not much we can do. It won't be here anymore. Do you think that... Why is the comlink to HQ back on?
Did I undo that already?
Can't be. I just saw him heading to the generator. Bloody hell. Phil, they didn't listen. They sent someone.
Goddamn Rama executives.
You there, in the comm station. I am the operating director here, Amanda Pohl. Listen, there is no time to explain, but all the mission data is being loaded in the cargo train.
This is Saturn HQ. Good, we have the comm link up. Thank you. Next, you should head to Base M. On your way there, you could lower the weather station telescope to protect it from the storm. HQ out.
Data barrel, and we're done.
Copy that, Amy. I found the generator's control rod automation. I'll bypass it now.
I love the look of it. It definitely has that Alien Isolation older kind of style feel to it. This is an alternate timeline where JFK was not assassinated, so.
The generator is done. Heading to the comm station next.
Ion, didn't you hear? Rama sent a replacement and the comm link is already up. They didn't listen to us.
What? I better hurry then.
So I'm going to try to get you guys immersed into this as much as possible. game will be available very, very soon, probably a day after this video shows up on YouTube, I guess. For this this game. And of course, it's for Steam. I don't know if it's for any other system. Looks like an Otacon there. So you collect different things. These are shows up where all the collectibles are. These are like tapes you can listen to and badges and stuff. So pretty cool. Trippy. And it's only gonna get trippier. So you can't go that way, so we're gonna have to go back around. We actually just picked up what we needed to continue on here. You get no help really from anything. You gotta figure all this out by yourself, and I love that. No hand-holding or anything like that. Now you can actually go back into the other part by, you know, continuing that. But we're actually going to continue on during this section here. See, there's some pollen there. All kinds of things to discover. I mean, everything you can pretty much pick up. We have no power in here, so that means we need to continue on. Love the look of the game. I think they did a really great job. Very atmospheric. So we picked up another tape, so we'll listen to that soon. That looks like a psychotic cat right there. Always gotta have a good cat.
the airlock. I took the jackhammer, removed the outer door, and I don't know what to make of this. I know this is connected to that thing in the cave. The entity. After all the time I've been here, the things I've seen, I'm beginning to think there won't be a rescue.
I think we may have listened to that one already. So let's... Yeah, we did. Sorry about that. These are the two that we haven't listened to yet.
I began recording these messages for the researchers, but I guess I'm doing this for myself now. I only found a couple of cassettes, so I had to tape over the old ones. I think this one is going through its 6th re-recording already. The boredom's really been getting to me. Out of desperation, I've decided to break into the study library. I had to manually override the door system. You know, things are getting bad when you're resorting to breaking and entering just to read some of Philip's literary classics. By the time I get out of here, I'll probably be the most sophisticated Raman technician in the solar system.
Whoa, what was that? That scared the crap out of me right there. Alright, a little more tape here.
Oh, fuck it. I'm holding on to whatever keeps me even close to sane. Yeah, Karen. Don't give it up just yet. I'm so tired of hoping for any goddamn thing anymore. I'm tired of this loop. I'm tired of calling it life. Oh, it's getting quite stifling in here. I'm thinking about moving into the lab. Stop avoiding the thing in there. The atmosphere there feels somehow lighter.
I'm really, really enjoying the story of this so far. And looks like we found one more, so we'll go ahead and play that last one, and then we'll move on.
Yeah, it's Karen. Nothing in the base changes. My hair and fingernails were not growing. I think time was standing still. I dream about Ethan and Jessica every night. Even the drugs don't numb the dreams anymore. Yet I keep taking them. In some of the dreams, I'm back at home. But they act like I'm dead. Not hearing anything I say and just looking right through me. I keep telling myself, they're only nightmares. I'm alive. I know I'm alive. Patrick is dead. But I am alive. I want him to have a face again.
Alright, so we've collected quite a few so far. We got the welcome sign, I guess. You don't really know what... I guess they light up a little bit differently, the collectibles that you can actually pick up that mean something. Alright, so there's like a certain thing that you have to do in order to get these. Let's, not sure which one it is. It's probably on that welcome sign, right? Okay, so disconnect. A, B, C, D, E. Manual override, disconnect B and E. It's back in the right spot. Pretty cool to figure those things out. Before I move on, so you can tell that that's going to be the next portion here, we're going to go down here. Make sure we don't skip anything. So picked up two more tapes. Alright, I think that's gonna be good, so let's check out the this alternate loop, I guess, or something. I don't know how you explain. Ooh, is that a ladder? Oh, okay, that's cool. See where, like, time slows down and then gravity loses itself. And here we are, I guess, back in the present. Ooh, look what happened to that person. Oh, this is cool. Alright, so you're guiding this thing, I guess, through. It's getting harder. Oh, this is cool. Wow, I don't even know how I've got this far yet. No. Oh. Try to beat my high score, everybody. That's crazy. Oh, that's cool. You can input your own name. I'm number one. Oh, you probably have to close it. Kind of sets the atmosphere for the room. That's pretty cool. Probably going to be really hard for anybody to read that. All right. Very, very cool. Guys, this is a game you're going to want to pick up and try. I'm having a blast playing this. The atmosphere just feels great. I know that cat. Oh, so like if you wanted to cook something. Fridge. Notice the thing he keeps. He actually mentions something. Like that. Alright. Oh, if only you could drink it, that'd been so cool. Do the right thing. We don't loiter. Good strain. Now, we didn't check up here before because there was nothing up here. I think you might be able to get into the rooms now. That's cool. So you need their access card to get into the rooms. few more tapes. Come on, how cool is that? We just took pictures inside the environment. That was awesome. I know, I get amused easily at things. Yes, very true. Still, though, that's really cool. Got a few more tapes here. Just plug the toilet. All right, two more left. Just because if I'm afraid of copyright or something like that.
I just read that without external circadian cues, human day lengths can vary between 18 and 52 hours. So I can't rely on my sleeping rhythm when estimating time. It's probably around mid-April. And time for yet another diary entry from yours truly. I've managed to break into every room on the station in search of anything worth salvaging. Mainly I've been looking for some entertainment and ways to record this diary. Lan's music cassettes have been the most handy for that task, and frankly, I feel he owed them to me. The thing in the lab gives me the creeps. It makes me feel so warm and soothing. But my rational mind refuses to comprehend it. I try to visit the lab as little as possible because something just feels out of place.
All right, I think we've read all the tapes. There's still quite a few tapes left. I mean, coins. Other things that we haven't got here, and we use that. Oh, no. You gotta do it when you're away. I don't think we got his. Nope. We did get one other person's. Must be this one. He definitely likes it more clean. So you can read it by clicking it in, okay. He doesn't really have much to discover in here. Aha! So go back into that other room and grab tape. Listen to this one. Maybe we missed that the first time. Maybe that other guy had a space like this as well. What that's for. Okay, that's probably going to be about it in here, so let's exit. Hopefully you guys enjoying the gameplay. I gotta say, this is actually really, really fun. And let's see if there was one of those. Yeah, I totally didn't even notice that. Listen to this tape we got. It's got a weird thing on it. It's just a music. Apologize if I missed anything. We only have two, so there's no real reason to search anyone else. Wonder what this is. Okay, so let me tell you guys, the trick about of actually throwing things in here is you actually have to hold it down. $280, wow. I wonder if there's an achievement for actually beating that. Oh my gosh. It keeps pushing you off. Look at him breathing hard. We're gonna make one. Oh yeah! Oh, that was great. We already did that, so we did that in the other side. All right. How could that not motivate or pump anybody up? They put a lot of time and effort into this. I love how he's breathing hard now, you know? I bet you this really would look amazing in 4K. So you guys know exactly where we are, except everything looks definitely a lot better.
Flowers are blooming and developing better than expected. Approximately 115% fertility rate. I saw some bees buzzing around the lab's vent. Someone has to check if they have a hive there. Probably the heat from the generator lures them into the vents. Electromagnetic and radiation measurements are average in hydroponics. I should look for another reason for the entity's effect on plants. Could the honey flavor and color be due to abnormal crystallization?
Whatever it did, it stopped that little thing from going over there. There's still no communication. Now, it might be a little hard for you guys to read, but... something about that in the middle.
Carefully constructing a timeline of the unusual behavior of the people here since the piece of the entity was brought into the lab, I've come to a conclusion. The MRI scans and measurements of common hormone levels all indicate that everyone here is experiencing the same condition, homesickness. The entity is affecting our brains, which leads to changes in our moods and desires. Everything's amplified after we brought the sample here. And the people that have been closest to it have experienced the most severe effects. Symptoms that were initially weak and varying have now coalesced and strengthened into severe homesickness. I think we need to get rid of the entity. I have studied the gravity beam, and I am fairly certain I can use it to destroy the sample.
Trying to search as much of this stuff as possible, guys. Got another one, right? Okay. So before we go back into that other world, let's look around for just a second more here. (Laughs) Just touching buttons. Nothing big. Oh shit. Ooh, I got it in there. I'm just messing with so many buttons here. No idea what they do. Alright, so... Well... There's a rift that's gonna take us into that other realm, which will get us back to the other side, I guess. The darker side. However you want to call it. Just so many places to go. That's locked. So many buttons to press. So we can't go to the reactor. Let's go check out the rift. That's maybe where that's supposed to send to. Ah. Okay. They're keys. So where is... There it is. No, it's just a shoe. Usually means that there's something here that we can pick up that's going to... take us into that other world. world or something. I don't know. But I'm not seeing anything. There. Maybe it's underneath. Is that it? Well, guys, as of right now, we don't know if we should continue on there or if it's got to be something around here. Usually that's what it is. If you see something like this, that means... I like that because there's no gravity right there. Alright guys, well this is where we're going to stop the video. Wanted to show you guys some gameplay, obviously, for this game, so hopefully you guys enjoyed. Let me know if you want to see more. Really, actually enjoy playing this so far. It looks really, really cool. Wow. Alright, well thanks for watching guys, and of course I'll see you next time. Peace out.